This problem is a lot like other word problems, where the hardest part is actually setting up the system of equations. The solving part is not going to be too bad. In this case, we need to define some variables first. So we are asked to find a number of dimes and a number of quarters. And so that suggests that we need two variables, and they should represent dimes and quarters. So let's suppose that x could be our number of dimes. And we could say y could be the number of quarters. So now we need to come up with some equations that involve x and y. Well, the first thing that we are told is that we have a total of 26 coins. So we can make the equation from that the number of dimes plus the number of quarters should be 26. Because we have 26 coins total, and they are either dimes or quarters. The second equation is going to come from our total value of the coins, which is $4.10. Now, in this case, we are going to either have to make a conversion between cents to dollars or dollars to cents. In this case, I don't like decimals, and so I'm going to say that $4.10 is the same as 410 cents. And so we know that the total value of our coins is going to be 410. Now, how does that relate to x and y? Well, we know that x is our number of dimes. And so if we took our number of dimes and we multiplied it by 10, that would tell us how much those dimes are worth, right? Because each dime is 10 cents. So in other words, 10 times the number of dimes would be the value of those dimes. And then same idea, each quarter is worth 25 cents. And so if we take our number of quarters and multiply it by 25, that would tell us the value of those quarters. So now we have the two equations in our system. Here we have equation number one, and here we have equation number two. And now it's a matter of solving the system to figuring out the values of x and y. In this case, probably the substitution method is going to be easiest. What we could do is take equation 1 and get the y by itself. So let's do that. What we'd want to do is subtract x from each side. And that leaves us with y equals negative x plus 26. And now we're going to take this expression and substitute it for the y in equation 2. So that turns equation 2 into this. We still have 10x like we had before. And now we're going to have plus 25 times the thing that we're substituting for y. So negative x plus 26 equals 410. So equation is a little bit uglier than it was before, but we only have one variable, which means we can solve it and get a number. So let's do that. We first have to take our 25, and we're going to distribute it inside the parentheses here. And what that gives us is 10x minus 25x plus 650 equals 410. So a little bit of combining like terms here. 10x minus 25x is negative 15x plus 650 equals 410. And now we need to get the x by itself. So we can move this 650 over by subtracting from each side, leaving us with negative 15x equals negative 240. And then the last step is to divide by negative 15, which tells us that x equals 16. So before we go on, what that tells us is that we have 16 dimes. That's half of our answer right there. Now we have to come back and get the other half of the answer. Probably the easiest thing to do is take the 16 that we just found and plug it into equation 1, where the x goes. What that tells us, if we do that, is 16 plus y equals 26. Get the y by itself by subtracting 16 from both sides. And so what do we see? Y is equal to 10. That is our number of quarters. So putting it all together, what do we have? We have 16 dimes and 10 quarters.